4th Annual Miss Universe Pageant. From the Miami Convention Center in Miami, Florida, 79 of the world's most beautiful young women, plus our host, Bob Barker. Our hostess, Joan Van Ark. Musical guest, Whit Holmes. Special guest star, John Denver. And Miss Universe 1984, Yvonne Reading.
In the next 2 hours, there will be a new Miss Universe. She will get a new crown and a new attitude. Whoever she might be. Here are the contestants in the Miss Universe Parade of Nations, beginning with Miss Argentina.
Hello, my name is Janina Castaño and I come from Olavarría, Argentina.
Buenas noches. Buenas noches, my name is Elizabeth and I represent the city of Brisbane in Queensland, Australia.
Good evening, my name is Martina Heiden. I come from Vienna, Austria.
Good evening, my name is Cleopatra Adelaide and I'm from beautiful Nassau in the Bahamas.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Elizabeth and I bring you greetings from the beautiful island of Barbados.
Hi, good evening, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Anne van den Broek. I'm from Antwerp, Belgium. Thank you.
Good evening, I'm Jennifer Woods representing Belize. Thank you.
Good evening, everyone. My name is Janelle Ford, and I bring you warm greetings from Devonshire, Bermuda.
Buenas noches. Soy Gabriel Orozco, y vengo de Bolivia.
Good evening. Meu nome é Marta Jéssica Navelo de Oliveira. Represento Mato Grosso, Brasil.
Good evening, everyone. I am Jennifer Leonora Penn, representing the beautiful British Virgin Islands.
Good evening, everyone. My name is Karen Tilley, and I'm from Calgary, Alberta, Canada.
Good evening, I'm Emily Hurlston from Grand Cayman, Cayman Islands.
Muy buenas noches, señoras y señores. Mi nombre es Claudia Vancintián y vengo a San Fernando, Chile.
Good evening, my name is Sandra Borda and I come from Cartagena, Colombia.
Good evening, everyone. My name is Esti Boxupo, representing the Cook Islands.
Buenas noches, mi nombre es Rosibel Chacón y represento el bello país de Costa Rica.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Shade Waver, and I come from the beautiful island of the Caribbean, Curaçao.
Good evening, my name is Andrea Andreo, and I come from Limassol, Cyprus.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Susan Rasmussen, and I come from Copenhagen in Denmark.
Muy buenas noches, querido público. Soy Mayra Vicente desde la República Dominicana, la tierra del merengue.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Margaret Rose Cruz-Lartigue, and I come from the nature island of the Caribbean, Dominica.
Good evening, my name is Maria Elena Stangel, and I come from Guayaquil, Ecuador. Thanks.
Muy buenas noches, señoras y señores. Mi nombre es Julia Idemora, y represento la República del Salvador. Gracias.
Hello, I'm Helen Westlake from Bristol in England.
My name is Maria Kinnunen, and I come from Jämsä, Finland.
Bonsoir, Suzanne Iskandar, Strasbourg, France.
Good evening, everyone. My name is Batulu Yalo from Banyun, the Gambia.
Good evening. My name is Stephanie Roth, and I'm from Trier, Germany.
Hello, I'm Karina Hollands, and I come from the Rock of Gibraltar.
Good evening. My name is Sabina Damianidis, and I come from Athens in Greece.
Hafiday, and good evening, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Lucy Carbolito Montanola, and I'm from the beautiful island of Guam.
Good evening, everyone. My name is Perla Pereira, and I come from Guatemala.
Good evening. My name is Ariel Gentil, Port-au-Prince, Haiti.
Good evening, everybody. My name is Bridget Bergman. I'm from Utrecht, Holland.
Buenas noches. Mi nombre es Diana Margarita García, y represento con mucho orgullo Puerto Cortés, Honduras.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Sherry, come from Hong Kong.
Good evening. My name is Hadla Brinsjonsson from Reykjavik, Iceland.
Namaste. I'm Sonia, and I'm from Bombay, India.
Hello, everybody. I'm Olivia Tracy from Dublin, Ireland.
Good evening, everybody. My name is Ilak Helman, and I'm from Cologne, Israel.
Ciao a tutti. Io sono Beatrice Papi. Vengo dalla bellissima Firenze, Italia.
Konbanwa. My name is Hatsumi Furusawa. Come from Osaka, Japan.
Good evening, everyone. My name is Yongosie. I'm from Seoul, Korea.
Good evening. I'm Joyce Sahab from Beirut, Lebanon.
Hi, I'm Gabrielle Chiarini from Luxembourg.
Good evening. My name is Agnes Chin. I'm from Kuantan Pahang, Malaysia.
Good evening. My name is Fiona McAuliffe, and I come from Bristol, Island, Malta.
Hola, muy buenas noches. Soy Yolanda Cárdenas de Sinaloa, México.
Hello, I'm Claire Glenister from Auckland, New Zealand.
Good evening. My name is Tatiana Marie Flores, and I come from the Northern Marianas.
Good evening, everybody. My name is Karen Margrethe Mu. I come from Kristiansand, Norway.
Muy buenas noches a todos. Mi nombre es Janet Vázquez y vengo de la ciudad de Panamá, República de Panamá.
Good evening, everybody. My name is Kamal. I bring you greetings from my country, Papua New Guinea.
Good evening. My name is Beverly Ocampo-Gadea, and I come from Asunción, Paraguay.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Maria Gracia Galeno, and I'm from Lima, Peru.
Buenas noches. I'm Joyce Villosas Burton, and I have greetings from Manila, Philippines, to the whole wide world. Mabuhay!
Good evening. My name is Katarzyna Zawicka. I am from Poland.
Good evening, everyone. My name is Alexandra Gomes, and I come from Portugal.
Hello, I'm Deborah Carthy, and I come from the beautiful and only island of the sun, Puerto Rico.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Dominique de la Sévignon, Saint-Denis, Île de la Réunion.
Hello, my name is Jackie, and I come from Glasgow in Scotland.
Bonsoir, je m'appelle Chantal Belay, je représente le Sénégal.
Good evening, my name is Liana from Singapore.
Buenas noches, soy Teresa Sánchez y vengo desde Sevilla, España.
Hi, Bowen. Ramani Bethalemus from Sri Lanka.
Good evening, my name is Karina Malcolm from Eskilstuna, Sweden.
Bonsoir, Hinat Ikilion from Ete, Tahiti.
Good evening, my name is Sandy Fonsuk, I'm from Bangkok, Thailand.
Good evening, my name is Brenda Joy, and I bring you sunshine and love from Trinidad and Tobago.
Good evening, everyone. My name is Miriam Adams, and I represent the Turks and Caicos Islands.
Hello, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Andrea Lopez, and I came from Montevideo, Uruguay.
Hello, I'm Laura Martinez Herring from El Paso, Texas, USA.
Greetings, I'm Edith Henderson from St. Croix, the United States Virgin Islands.
Good evening, everybody. My name is Silvia Martinez. I come from Caracas, Venezuela.
Noswaithai Higid, I'm Barbara Christian from Pontypridd in Wales.
Good evening, everyone. My name is Falenaochi Tracy Mihalovich from the beautiful island of Apia, Western Samoa.
Good evening. My name is Dinka Delic from Sarajevo, representative Yugoslavia.
Bonsoir, je m'appelle Vinita Mureka, je représente le Zaïre.
And now, along with the international rhythm groups of Miami, here are musical guest Lynn Holmes. Special guest star, John Denver. Our hostess from Knott's Landing, Miss Joan Van Ark. Television personality and the star of The Price is Right, our host, Bob Barker.
Now where I'm going and I know what to do.
ladies and gentlemen, your host, Bob Barker. Welcome to the beautiful Miami Convention Center, and if you'll stay right there, I can promise you an exciting evening. 79 of the most beautiful young women in the world, with one of them being chosen Miss Universe 1985 by a panel of celebrity judges. Also, the talents of musical superstar John Denver. Add to all that the vitality and unpredictability that accompany the most special word in television, live, and you have the 34th annual Miss Universe pageant. And as it all happens, you and I get to enjoy the charming company of Knott's Landing's Valene Ewing, Joan Van Ark.
Thank you. Thank you very much. Bob? You know what, it gives me goosebumps to think about it, but did you know that there are some 700 million people estimated to watch tonight's pageant?
That's right, and since all of them would like another look at our contestants, they're going to get it right now.
Good.
The preliminary swimsuit competition was held on this stage during the past week. What we're about to see is a special swimsuit fashion segment, which was taped at some of the most picturesque and colorful locations in the Miami area.
The young ladies tonight are wearing specially designed swimsuits by Catalina, and it will all be described by the handsome gentleman right here on my right, Mr. Bob Barker.
Thank you, Joan.
You're welcome.
Arriving at the Port of Miami with the city skyline in the background is the MS Holiday of the Carnival Lines. It's here that our fashion show begins, and it's here that our young ladies really took over. We found the skipper on the bridge, on the console, and on the phone. She's Miss USA, Lauda Herring, with Tharnthip Pongsuk, Miss Thailand. The rail is a sunning spot for Miss Panama, Janet Vasquez. This charming crew member is Miss US Virgin Islands, Mudit Alda Henderson. The ship's round pool is a meeting place for Miss Wales, Barbara Christiane, and Beverly Ocampos, Miss Paraguay. Three lovely ladies who sit up and take notice are Miss Trinidad Tobago, Brenda Joy Fahey, Mardia Keenanen, Miss Finland, and Miss Luxembourg, Gabi Chiarini. What do pretty lookouts see? Other pretty lookouts. Here are Miss Western Samoa, Helen Tracy Mihalovich, and Miss Holland, Bridget Bergman. We move from the cruise ship to the coast of Miami Beach and the fountains at the Fontainebleau Hilton Hotel, where we join Miss Costa Rica, Rosibel Chacon, and Malena Stengel Tamayo, Miss Ecuador. From the fountains, we move across the hotel grounds to the pool, and there we find rocks, waterfalls, and palm trees, providing a beautiful background for Miss Malaysia, who is Agnes Chin. From behind the trees, we greet Miss Senegal, Chantal Lubello, and Miriam Adams, who is Miss Turks and Caicos. Pool in front, waterfall in back, and in between is Miss Peru, Maria Gracia Galeno. By this catamaran, we find two beauties, Miss Yugoslavia, Dinka Delic, and in a lemon neon suit, Andrea Lopez, Miss Uruguay. The beach umbrella falls to reveal Miss Gibraltar, Karina Hollins, and Claire Glenister, who is Miss New Zealand. The beach ball, not the shamrock, leads us to Miss Ireland, Olivia Tracy. The cargo on this popcorn cart is Lucy Carbolito Montinola, Miss Guam. And sitting in this fancy beach chair is Miss Poland, Katarina Zawicka. This park in the shadow of Florida's famous highway I-95 is named for Cuban patriot Jose Marti. And in her pony print suit, we meet Miss Italy, Beatrice Papi. And Sonia Walia, Miss India. Relaxing in front of a park waterfall is Susan Rasmussen, Miss Denmark, along with two Latin lovelies, Deborah Carthy Du, Miss Puerto Rico, and Miss Bolivia, Gabriela Orozco Ruiz. On the edge of this pool, we find Miss Belize, Jenny Woods. A young lady from an old country, Miss Greece, Sabina Damianidis, turns her attention to Miss Curacao, Shaida Weaver.
We finish our visit to Jose Marti Park watching Melba Vicens' Miss Dominican Republic. The Falls is both the name and the description of a shopping complex in metropolitan Dade County, where at one of several lagoons we find Miss Cayman Islands, Emily Hurlston, and wearing a lattice side tank suit, young Oak Choi, who is Miss Korea. A polka dot umbrella leads us to Miss Cyprus, Andre Andreu, and the water's a little cool for Miss Portugal, Alexandra Mota Gomez. What are these three young ladies keeping under their hats? Three pretty faces. Miss France is Suzanne Iskandar, Miss Malta is Fiona Micheliff, and Miss Brazil is Marcia Jajo Canaveses. These back-to-back beauties are Miss Haiti, Ariel Jonti, and Julia Mora, Miss El Salvador. The swimming pool at the Key Biscayne Hotel and Villas is Olympic size, and like the Olympics, attracts swimmers from all over the world. For example, Carmel Ann Vaughy, Miss Papua New Guinea, and Jackie Hendry, a bonny lassie who is Miss Scotland. The mast is that of the USS Flirt, and at a replica of it is Miss Venezuela, Sylvia Martinez, and on the stern is Yolanda Cardenas Aviles, Miss Mexico. This twosome is Jennifer Leonora Penn, Miss British Virgin Islands, and Miss Barbados, Elizabeth Wadman. Modeling her swimsuit of spandex and lace for us is Miss Australia, Elizabeth Bowley, whose audience also includes Miss Cook Islands, Essie Mokutupu, and Janelle Ford, Miss Bermuda. The marina at Monte Trainer's Restaurant provides a safe haven for trim boats and a backdrop for trim young contestants like this one, Miss Chile, Claudia Vancintion, and her fellow crew member and sunbather, Miss Sri Lanka, Ramani Elizabeth Bartholomews. It's sunglasses up for Miss Iceland, Halla Brindis. It takes something called the right stuff to carry Miss Universe to the top, and it takes a boat called the right stuff to carry our contestants here, where we find two Oriental beauties, Miss Singapore, Liana Chuck, and Miss Japan, Hatsumi Furusawa. The boats in the marina seem to have the attention of Miss Honduras, Diana Garcia, while fishing in a cheetah print suit is Miss Zaire, Benita Mareka Tete. Keeping a sharp lookout and a sharp look is Miss Belgium, Anne Vandenbroek. The Atlantic Ocean and beautiful palm trees surround the pool at the Ocean Reef Club in the beautiful Florida Keys, and from that pool comes this lovely senorita, Miss Spain, Teresa Sanchez. Who wouldn't want to be saved by such lovely lifeguards as Antoinette Flores, Miss Northern Marianas, and Martina Haydn, who is Miss Austria? This tropical setting seems appropriate for Miss Tahiti, Hinari Killian. In her zigzag stripe, high thigh suit, the bubbling waters attract Miss Dominica, Margaret Rose Lateef. Europe and Asia clink glasses at a poolside table. Miss Germany is Stephanie Roth, and Joyce Filiosas Burton is Miss Philippines. Meanwhile, another group mixes the sun, the sand, and the shade of the palm trees. Here is Baturu Jallo, Miss Gambia, Miss Hong Kong, Charlene Shea, and Miss Bahamas, Cleopatra Adderley. It's anything but a Scandinavian setting for Miss Norway, Karen Moo, and a match of colors in flower and swimsuit for Miss Guatemala, Perla Freire. From behind this huge flower pot and from South America and Europe come Shanina Castaño, Miss Argentina, and Karina Marklund, Miss Sweden. A colorful pool at one of the private homes at Ocean Reef is enhanced by some flower petals and some lovely ladies like Miss Colombia, Sandra Borda. From the Mideast to Florida has come Miss Israel, Hila Kelman. A pretty flower for pretty Miss Canada, Karen Tilley, and for Miss Reunion, Dominique Delors-Serignon. And it's at this pool that we meet our final twosome of Joyce Sahab, Miss Lebanon, and in her mitered striped suit, Miss England, Helen Westlake. Now we're right back where we started our fashion segment, aboard the MS Holiday, where the water doesn't make big waves, but the contestants do, as they send an international hello to everyone from the 1985 Miss Universe pageant.
One of those lovely
lovely young women that you've just seen is going to become Miss Universe 1985. And she'll do it by the votes of that distinguished panel of celebrity judges you see right behind me. We're going to be telling you more about them later on. Each judge is linked to our master computer by means of a terminal, just like this one right here. During our areas of competition, which is personal interviews, swimsuits, and evening gowns, each judge will give each contestant a score. It could be anywhere from, say, a 1 to a 9.99. That figure then goes into our computer system right here, which averages the judges' votes and tabulates each young lady's score. And you're going to see those scores on your home screens throughout the evening. Those scores will not be seen here in this theater. The contestants up there won't know, not even the judges behind me will know, just you and me. And we'll even review the scores after each competition. So, have you already picked out several of our contestants as your favorites? Well, you're going to find out what kind of an armchair judge you are when Bob announces our semifinalists right after this word from CAMA.
For the past week, everyone here has been getting ready for tonight's show, including our celebrity judges, who have been diligently preparing for that most important decision, the naming of the new Miss Universe. The contestants were judged in the swimsuit competition, each young lady wearing an identical swimsuit, and in the evening gown competition, where each candidate wore a gown of her own choosing. And each judge personally interviewed each contestant with the aid of an interpreter when necessary. That judging led to this moment, the announcement of our 10 semifinalists. I'm about to pick up that list of names.
Now, as each semifinalist comes forward, you at home will see on your screen her average score for the three preliminary competitions. Now let's get back to Bob with those important results.
Now before I read the names, which will be in no particular order, I would like to thank each and every young woman on this stage for her contribution to the pageant. You and your country should be proud. Now, here we go with the names of the 10 semifinalists, one of whom will become Miss Universe. Number one on the list, Miss Ireland. The second name on the list is Miss Uruguay. And another Latin, Miss Chile. How do you folks like Miss Canada? We're halfway there. Number five is Miss Brazil. And we want Miss Puerto Rico. Next is Miss Zaire. And now, come on down, Miss USA. Next to join this group is Miss Spain. Now the the last name on the list, the last contestant who has a chance to become Miss Universe is Miss Venezuela. Congratulations to the semi-finalists in the 1985 Miss Universe pageant.
Okay, you judges at home, now you know. So how did you do? How many of your choices became semi-finalists? Remember, from now on, everything our celebrity panel sees and hears, you'll also see and hear. Plus, you'll have the advantage of seeing the scores that each contestant gets. Now, our top three scores in the preliminary competition were first place, Miss Spain. Second place, Miss Venezuela. Third place, Miss Canada. The countdown from 10 semifinalists to 5 finalists begins when Bob starts the interview competition right after this word from Scope.
I mentioned at the Miss USA pageant that next to telling some young lady she's the winner, the interview competition is my favorite part of the pageant. It's about as unpredictable as live television can get, and it's fun. Tonight, I have the help of Professional Translating Services Incorporated, official interpreters of the 1985 Miss Universe pageant. We are going to begin with you, Miss Ireland. She is Olivia Tracy, 25, lives in Dublin, a graduate of Dublin University, and in what do you have a degree?
I have a degree in English and French, and I qualified as a teacher of English and French, and there was no such thing as a job, so I ended up becoming a model.
And these languages are the reason that you've been so helpful as an interpreter during our rehearsal.
Well, it was nice to be able to help Tad out. She worked very hard, and I was glad that I could do something to help her.
Now, I understand that as Miss Ireland, you have toured the United States.
That's right, Jess. Last March, you know, for St. Patrick's Week. It's not a day here. It's a week-long celebration.
What cities did you see?
I was taken over. In fact, my mother came with me as my chaperone. She had all the fun. I had all the work. But they took me to Los Angeles, San Francisco, Phoenix, Atlanta, Chicago, Pittsburgh, and eventually Philadelphia. And then I fell home.
I thought you saw Atlanta. Did you mention Atlanta?
Yes, Atlanta.
Yeah.
I was there for a day.
Did you pick up a southern accent down there?
Well, if you want me to do the southern accent, I could do it if you want.
Thank you, Miss Ireland. You definitely went to Atlanta. And now, Miss Uruguay, would you step out here? And she'd like to have an interpreter. She is Andrea Lopez. She's 17. She lives in Montevideo, and she's a high school student. Ask her what she's going to do when she finishes high school.
¿Qué vas a hacer al terminar tus estudios de bachillerato?
Bueno, empezar mi carrera, que es educación física.
I'm going to start on my career, which is physical education.
I saw in her bio that she teaches aerobics to children and to old people. How old are these old people doing aerobics?
Vi en tu biografía que le enseñas ejercicios aeróbicos a niños y a personas mayores. ¿Qué edad tienen las personas mayores?
Bueno, entre 30 y 50.
Well, between 30 and 50.
30 and 50. I don't know whether I can go on now. Well, I think that if she is going to teach English, she should have learned some English by now. You can say something to our audience in English, can't you, Miss Uruguay?
Yes, I can. I want to thank all of the people here in Miami, the organizations, and I want to say I love all of you. Thank you.
Thank you, Miss Uruguay. Next is Miss Chile, and she too would like to have an interpreter. She is Claudia Van Cintion, 19, lives in San Fernando, and she's a university student. What does she study?
¿Qué estás estudiando en la universidad?
Estudio ganadería.
I'm studying cattle breeding.
Cattle breeding. What would she like to do in the future?
¿Qué quisieras hacer en un futuro?
Trabajar en un campo, dedicarme a cuidar animales que me gustan mucho.
I would like to work in the country and engage in taking care of animals which I love very much.
Does she live on a farm now?
¿Tú vives en un fundo, en una finca, en este momento?
Se podría decir que sí. Me estoy trasladando a la ciudad, pero la mayor parte del tiempo la paso en campo.
You could say so. I am moving to the city, but I do spend most of my time out in the country.
And does she have pets?
¿Y tienes mascotas?
Muchas.
Many.
In the United States, we have a campaign to help control the pet population. Have your pets spayed or neutered. Has she heard that?
Tú sabes que en Estados Unidos tenemos una campaña para neutralizar a las mascotas, o sea, para que no puedan procrear. ¿Has oído decirte, has oído hablar de eso?
No, qué pena.
Well, she's heard it now. Thank you. Thank you very much. I want to talk with you, Miss Canada. Karen Tilley, 21, lives in Calgary. Now, being Miss Canada is a full-time job, but you were going to college, weren't you?
Yes, I was, prior to becoming Miss Canada.
Where were you going to school?
I was going to Mount Royal College in Calgary.
And what were you studying?
Business administration.
Uh-huh. What would you like to do in the future?
I'd like to get into marketing, public relations, something along that line.
Very good. I saw in your bio that you do not have a boyfriend.
No.
What are you looking for in a young man?
Height.
Height? How tall are you?
I'm 5'10".
5'10". I'll tell you what. All of the men in the audience who are over 6 feet and single, stand up. Stand up. Take your pick. In a way, cut that out. There's a short guy standing on his chair up there. That won't do. Thank you, Miss Kennedy.
Thank you.
All right, Miss Brazil, she too would like to have an interpreter. She is Marcia Giagio Canaveses, 21, lives in Rio de Janeiro, and she is a model. Ask her what she has enjoyed most here at the pageant.
O que é a coisa que você gostou demais aqui no concurso?
Olha, eu gostei das pessoas, das amizades que eu fiz aqui.
I enjoyed the people and all of the friends that I made here.
De conhecer outras culturas, de... Sabe, eu acho que agora tomei um pouco de consciência de que estamos cada vez mais unidos e que deixamos um pouco de guerras e que somos irmãos e tomei mais consciência disso.
She's enjoyed a lot of things.
Yes, she has. I have learned about other cultures and I have learned, I have become more conscious of the fact that we certainly can become more united in the world and try to avoid some of the negativity in it.
Well, that's nicely said. Now, our winner will receive almost $250,000 in cash and prizes. What would she do with all that money?
O que é que você vai fazer com todo o dinheiro se ganha?
Bom, eu pretendo, sabe, dividir para um pouco para mim, é claro, que eu acho que é essencial. E eu poder, já que tem uma obra tão bonita aqui nos Estados Unidos do USA Africa, eu vou doar um pouco para ela.
I think she has a lot of bills, doesn't she?
I would like to keep some for myself. That's quite essential right now. And also, I would like to put some into charity for USAF.
Well, that's very nice. Thank you, Miss Brazil. Thank you for your help. We have talked with half of our semifinalists, and we'll be back to talk to the others after these messages. We continue now with you, Miss Puerto Rico. She's Deborah Carthy Du. She's 19, lives in San Juan. She attends the University of Puerto Rico, and what do you study?
I'm studying humanities, and I would like to major in theater and have a minor in languages.
Now, to qualify as a Miss Universe contestant, our young ladies must win other pageants in their home countries, and yours were particularly exciting, weren't they? Why don't you tell our viewers about your pageants?
Okay, my first pageant was to win the Miss San Juan title, and it was quite exciting because we had a big fire on stage on our opening number, and it was quite scary, let me tell you, because we had to go out and be removed from the stage by the firemen and the water. Oh, huge mess. And then we had to wait for 4 hours for it to go on again. Finally, at 5:30 a.m., I was crowned as Miss San Juan. Then I got chicken pox, and then I went into the Miss Puerto Rico pageant, and it rained all night long, and it was outdoors.
Now, you see, just to be here in Miami, she has gone through fire, flood, everything but pestilence to be with us tonight. Thank you, Ms. Puerto Rico. Miss Zaire, please. And she will want an interpreter. She is Benita Marika Tete, 18, lives in Kinshasa. She's a high school student. Ask her what she plans to do when she finishes high school, please.
Qu'est-ce que vous projetez faire une fois que vous ayez fini votre bachot?
Mon quoi?
Pardon?
Qu'est-ce que vous avez dit? J'ai pas bien compris.
I did not understand that fully.
You. She does not understand that fully, or you do not understand that fully? I think they have their own show going here. When she graduates from high school, what does she want to do?
Une fois que vous ayez fini avec vos études, qu'est-ce que vous voulez faire?
Je voudrais faire la secrétaire. Je voudrais bien être une secrétaire de direction.
I would like to become a secretary. I'd like to become an executive secretary.
Et après ça, faire l'esthétique, être une esthéticienne.
And after that, I'd like to become a cosmetologist.
More?
Et puis?
That's enough, huh? Well, now, many of our viewers probably know very little about Zaire. Ask her to tell them about her country.
Nous connaissons très peu à l'égard de votre pays, Zaire. Pouvez-vous nous décrire un peu le pays?
Ça se trouve dans l'Afrique centrale, vers l'ouest.
It is located in Central Africa.
Well, we did know that, yes. But are the mountains, or is it desert, or what?
Nous savions ça déjà, alors, mais y a-t-il des montagnes? Est-ce qu'il y a beaucoup de déserts, quoi?
Oui, il n'y a pas tellement de montagnes ni de déserts.
No, there aren't that many mountains, and there isn't that much desert.
I wonder what they have in Zaire. Thank you very much. Thank you. Come over here, Miss USA. She is Laura Martinez Herring, age 21. She lives in El Paso. And on May 13th, I crowned you Miss USA. And were they excited in Texas when you went home from the USA pageant?
My gosh, they sure were. I arrived and there was about 2,500 people waiting for me at the airport, and the plane arrived an hour and a half late. They all had balloons and they had little badges saying, "We love you, Laura." And they went through a parade and they had mariachis, 70 children dancing, and they made up a song for me. It was incredible.
And is it true that in addition to everything that you won on the Miss USA pageant, that they came up with $55,000 more in prizes in Texas?
Yes, they did. Individual people, friends and everything, they contributed and they gave me these prizes. And for me, the best feeling was just for them to have taken the time and the support and the love. I could not believe how happy they were. And that week, I was just full, that day, it was in 24 hours, I was full of appearances and children crying with flowers, and they shriveled up $1 million in the parade. It was very, very nice.
$55,000. I'd like to have you folks in Los Angeles know I'll be home tomorrow if you'd like to make plans. Thank you, Miss USA. It's your turn, Miss Spain. She would like to have an interpreter. She is Teresa Sanchez, age 20, lives in Sevilla, and she is a model. Many of the young ladies watching the telecast would like to be models. Ask her what advice she has for young ladies who want to be models.
Muchas de las chicas que están mirando este tele quisieran ser maniquís. ¿Qué consejos le pudiera dar a aquellas que desean ser maniquí?
Bueno, yo empecé desde muy pequeñita, desde que tenía 10 años a ser modelo. Entonces yo lo único que les digo es que si les gusta, que sigan adelante.
Well, I started quite young. When I was about 10 years old, that's when I first became a model. And I can tell them that if they do like it, they should proceed with it.
Very well. Now, you can speak some English. ¿Qué puede decir en inglés?
I love Miami.
We'll stop with that. Thank you. Thank you. And Miss Venezuela. She too will have an interpreter stand by, but you may not use the interpreter.
Yeah.
All right. She is Silvia Martinez, 20, lives in Caracas. She's a law student, and our interpreter will stand by, but you may be able to do this in English. You're studying law.
Yes.
How long, how many more years before you become an attorney?
Well, I have 2 more years left to become a law.
And then what type of law, what kind of law will you practice?
I like very much mercantile. I think I will work in mercantile.
Is this your first visit to the United States?
No, I came here before when I was a little girl. I have some family here in Michigan.
Michigan?
Yes.
What, did you see any more of the United States?
Yes, I have other family in New Jersey, New York, and Arkansas.
In Arkansas?
Yes, my grandparents.
They live in Arkansas?
Yes.
Why did they choose Arkansas?
Because it was too cold for them in Michigan.
If you're going to retire in the United States and it's too cold in Michigan, there's not much left but Arkansas, right?
And in Arkansas, it's too hot, I think.
It is warm there, but it's lovely. Thank you, Miss Venezuela. Thank you. There you have it. You know our semi-finalists a little better. And I have a hunch that a lot of you have changed from viewers to rooters.
Bob is right. A lot of you, I'd say most of you, are starting to root for some of our contestants. At least our live audience here is. Maybe you've made your choice already. In the interview competition, the judges gave the highest score to Miss Spain. Second place was Miss Venezuela. And third place went to Miss Zaire. Coming up, you'll get to meet those celebrity judges and enjoy the music of John Denver, my favorite. And that's right after this word from Secret, the official antiperspirant of the 1985 Miss Universe pageant.
There is one word that describes our guest star tonight as a concert performer, movie actor, recording artist, and television host. The word is superstar. His newest album is called Dreamland Express. And it's from that album that he brings us his hit single, Don't Close Your Eyes Tonight. Ladies and gentlemen, John Denver!
Loneliness that I feel, very real, you see. I can feel your body stir so deep within. Let it be an act of love tonight, completely. And let me ask of you one thing. Don't close your eyes tonight. Just look at me. See how many times I cried for you. Don't close your eyes tonight. Let it be me, not just a fantasy. Let it be me tonight. You can lie so close to someone, still feel all alone. Though I've heard you say you love me so many times, when you give me love so beautiful and tender, someone else is in your mind. Don't close. At me, see how many times I cried for you. Don't close your eyes tonight. Let it be me, not just a fantasy. Let it be me tonight. Sorry if I cry, but feelings run so deep. And many is the time when I wake up and find I've been crying in my sleep. Look me in the eye and tell me what you see. 'Cause I'm the one who loves you, I'm the one who needs you. Make this one for me. Don't close your eyes tonight. Just look at me. See how many times I cried for you. Don't close your eyes tonight. Let it be me. Just a fantasy. Let it be me tonight. Don't close your eyes tonight. Just look at me. See how many times I cried for you. Don't close your eyes tonight. Let it be me.
Great. There he is, John Denver, ladies and gentlemen. It was great, John. Now, I'd like to congratulate our panel of celebrity judges on a job well done. And I would like to introduce them. For 30 years, an internationally renowned couturier of Savile Row, one of the official dressmakers for Her Majesty the Queen of England, here is Hardy Ames. He was the murderer in Death on the Nile, was devoured by a 35-foot shark in Jaws 3D, and is currently starring in the CBS series Falcon Crest. He is Simon McCorkindale. An international concert and recording superstar here from her native Spain is Rocío Jurado. He received the prestigious Best Actor Award from the National Board of Review for his highly acclaimed portrayal of Dr. Assis in the Academy Award-winning A Passage to India. Please welcome Victor Banerjee. After spending the last year modeling, she's now preparing to open her own modeling and grooming school in her native New Zealand. She is fondly remembered as Miss Universe 1983. Welcome back, Lorraine Downs. She has recently completed the critically acclaimed London engagement of Clifford Odets, The Country Girl, and is looking forward to the release of her new film, Checkmate. Here is Susan George. He is an internationally renowned artist. His work is shown in the permanent collections of some 40 major museums. His next major exhibitions will take place in Rome, then Monte Carlo in November this year. Please welcome Dong Kingman. Her singing career, through many gold records and concert appearances, made her a legend, known throughout the Spanish-speaking world as Olga de Cuba. She is Olga Vilac. She received both Tony and Drama Desk nominations for her performance in the Broadway hit Dreamgirls, and her recent single, In the Evening, has climbed the record charts. An elegant thief turned undercover agent in the TV series Codename Foxfire, please greet Cheryl Lee Ralph. He has more than 40 books and screenplays to his credit, including The Green Berets and The French Connection, and has just completed a novel, Galleon Hunters, about treasure hunting in the Caribbean. Here is Robin Moore. She gained fame for her exciting choreography for 21 years on television with Jackie Gleason, for which she was honored on the 1984 Emmy Award telecast. Since 1978, she has directed and choreographed the dazzling routines of the Miami Dolphins cheerleaders. June Taylor! Our thanks to this distinguished panel of celebrity judges.
Beautiful, all of you look great. We are moments away from the swimsuit competition, and this dressing room, let me tell you, is a busy enough place without me being in here adding to all the confusion. But I wanted you at home to get a sense of the excitement level and how our semifinalists feel right now at this big moment. Tell me, please, in one word, and look out there so the world can see you, how do you feel right now?
It's exciting.
Exciting.
Nobody knows, I swear, how excited we are to be here.
Okay, how about you? One word, una word. How do you feel right now?
Sorry, but I don't speak English.
Oh, but she must be excited. Help.
No, you. Okay, ¿cómo te sientes ahora?
Muy bien, bien, contentísima.
Muy bien. Well, it's fingernail biting time around the world because our second competition, swimsuits, begins when we come back after this word from Crisco.
No city in the world provides a more magnificent setting for a swimsuit competition than Miami. And we have enhanced that by bringing you the modern beauty of our contestants against a background reminiscent of the classic beauty of a masterpiece, Botticelli's Venus Rising from the Sea. As each young woman comes front and center wearing her competition swimsuit by Catalina, our judges will enter a score on their computer terminals, and you viewers will see her average swimsuit score on your television screens. Ladies and gentlemen, the 1985 swimsuit competition. First, Miss Ireland.
Olivia is 25 years old, with green eyes and blonde hair. She weighs 124 pounds and is 5'8" tall.
Miss Uruguay.
At 17, Andrea weighs 135 pounds and stands 5'7" tall. Her hair is blonde and her eyes are green.
Miss Chile.
Claudia has green eyes and black hair. She is 5'8" tall, weighs 135 pounds, and she is 19 years old.
Miss Canada.
Standing 5'10" tall, Karen weighs 128 pounds. She is 21 years old, with blonde hair and blue eyes.
Miss Brazil.
At 21, Marcia is 5'8" tall and weighs 145 pounds. She has brown hair and brown eyes.
Miss Puerto Rico.
Deborah is a green-eyed brunette. She weighs 118 pounds and is 5'8" tall. Deborah is 19 years old.
Miss Zaire.
Benita Rita, has dark brown hair and dark brown eyes. She weighs 125 pounds and stands 5 feet 7 inches tall.
Miss USA.
Laura is 5 feet 7 inches tall and weighs 115 pounds. She is 21 years old with dark brown hair and dark brown eyes.
Miss Spain.
Teresa has light brown hair and light brown eyes. She weighs 122 pounds and is 5 feet 5 and a half inches tall.
Miss Venezuela.
Silvia is 5 feet 11 inches tall and weighs 135 pounds. Her hair is blonde and her eyes are brown. Silvia is 20 years old.
So our second competition has ended, and I wonder if you've changed your mind, or are you more certain than ever about your choice for our winner?
Well, it's time to see the scores again, and this time it's from the swimsuit competition. The judges gave the highest score, first place, to Miss Spain. Second place to Miss Uruguay. And third place to Miss Zaire. Now at this time, I'd like to cast a private vote for a lady who's not a contestant. Our choreographer, Tad Tadlock, worked with our 79 young women from all over the world, and together they have created a musical spy thriller that'll have you scratching your head and snapping your fingers at the same time. Let me tell you, that's not easy. You'll see what I mean later. But right now, this word from Duncan Hines Brownies.
That exciting spy number that Joan was talking about in a few moments, but first, I'd like to tell you that the record-setting total of cash and prizes that our winner receives this year is nearly $250,000. That includes a $25,000 personal appearance contract, a $15,000 first prize award, plus an impressive list of prizes that Joan is going to describe for us.
Miss Universe will fly first class with Eastern, whether she chooses the beautiful beaches of Florida, an enchanting Caribbean island, the splendor of South America, or Eastern's newest destination, London. She'll discover that at Eastern, we earn our wings every day. Miss Universe will receive a $5,000 cash award, video products, and the new Minolta Maxim autofocus system for perfect shots every time. What a splash you'll make with her brand new Minolta Maxim. Only from the mind of Minolta. Now that's a whale of a smile. Miss Universe contestants play hard too, and to get the tan they want, they choose Coppertone. Coppertone will present the winner with a $10,000 cash prize and a 5-year supply of Coppertone tanning products. Make all your days sunny ones with Coppertone. To keep Miss Universe looking and feeling luxurious, she will receive a $10,000 cash award plus a 5-year supply of UltraSense pantyhose, all from UltraSense, the look and feeling of luxury from no nonsense. The new Miss Universe will be ship-shape wherever she goes in her versatile sportswear that is equally stylish for cruising or personal appearances. She will receive a $10,000 cash award plus an all-season wardrobe from Catalina. Miss Universe will receive an all-expense-paid vacation for two to any place in the world that Pan Am flies, be it Europe, South America, the Caribbean, or the Far East. Pan Am, you can't beat the experience. To be on time at the falls or anywhere else, our winner receives an elegant, ultra-thin, 18-karat gold and diamond dress watch, especially made for her, plus a $10,000 cash award from dependable, affordably priced Loris Watches. She will receive $10,000 in cash, $1,000 in film processing, and a week's vacation in France, all from Kiss Photo, with mini labs in over 4,000 retail locations across the country. Miss Universe will receive the sporty 170 American Bow Rider from Wellcraft Marine Corporation, powered by a Yamaha 90 outboard motor. She will also receive a trailer from Shoreline Products. Miss Universe 1985 will receive, in addition to a $10,000 cash award, a 5-year supply of cosmetics from Maybelline, the official cosmetic for the Miss Universe pageant. The new Miss Universe will receive, in addition to a $5,000 cash award, a stunning and stylish $10,000 designer wardrobe by Fernando Pena, all from Secret, the official antiperspirant of the 1985 Miss Universe pageant. Tonight's winner will be able to go anywhere and everywhere in style, wearing this natural tourmaline mink coat, modeled here by the reigning Miss Universe at the Grand Bay Hotel. It's from the internationally famous Flemington Fur Company. In addition to a $10,000 cash prize, the new Miss Universe will step proudly with a complete Bass and Bear Trap wardrobe. Bass keeping up with the young, dynamic image of life in the fast lane that sets the pace for all Bass fashions. Wherever she decides to go, the new Miss Universe will be able to travel with the style, comfort, and dependability that mark one of America's most popular sports cars, the fully equipped 1985 Mazda RX-7 GSL. And Miss Universe will receive the very first brilliant 1 1/3 carat Lazar diamond, cut to ideal proportions and valued at over $25,000. The Lazar diamond setting the standard for brilliance. All of those wonderful prizes for the new Miss Universe and, of course, her beautiful jeweled crown, which Bob right here is about to show you.
Joan, I want to tell you that...
Just open the box, Bob, and show them the crown.
Well, I want to say...
No, Bob, just open the box, okay?
The thing is gone.
No.
The message on my answering service was confusing. Meet 79 other spies at midnight at the warehouse. Thieves to catch and not much time to catch them. Solving this could be your crowning achievement.
Shadows looking through an open window. Footsteps following wherever you go. Undercover eyes. Search to find the key to alibis. Living in a hideaway, you can't hide. You can never get away. We'll find you, be aware. We're everywhere, we spies in the night. We go wherever you are. You're in our sight. Watch out for spies in the cold.
I decided to drop in on the warehouse again and see if I could get a hook on this thing. It was a case of a lot of cases making my case tougher, and time was running out.
Diamond light.
Lover pie. Moves in space with minimum waste.
And maximum joy.
Face to face, each classic phase. We shadow box and double cross and need the change. Buenos Aires to Budapest, from north to south and east to west.
No need to ask their smooth operator.
Wonderful guest, Clint Holmes. You got the crown back.
Thank you. I will get it back to someone who can take care of it.
The winner, maybe. Nope. Now, I'm backstage with some ladies you're about to see in our evening gown competition, because during the pageant, each contestant was assigned a Miami area youngster to be her little sister. And these right here are the lucky little sisters of our 10 semifinalists. Do you think that your big sister's going to be the winner tonight?
Yes.
Why?
Because she's pretty.
She's pretty, that's a good enough reason. How about you? Would you like to be in the Miss Universe pageant when you grow up?
Yeah.
You think you'd win?
Yeah.
That's what I like, positive thinking. Well, you have just seen a preview of the 1999 Miss Universe pageant, and coming up soon is the 1985 evening gown competition. That and much more when we come back after this word from Duncan Hines, ready to serve cookies. You're gonna love it.
A show of the scope of the Miss Universe pageant relies heavily on the assistance and cooperation of people in the host city. With that in mind, this pageant would like to acknowledge some especially helpful officials. Mayor of the City of Miami, Maurice Ferrer, the honorary chairman of the Greater Miami Host Committee, Miami Vice Mayor, Joe Carollo, Mayor of Miami Beach, Malcolm Fromberg, and the Mayor of Monroe County, Wilhelmina Harvey. The Greater Miami Host Committee's chairman, Monty Traynor, and the chairman of the Miss Universe Committee for Miami, J.J. Skip Shepherd. Our thanks to all of you.
Between the exciting Spies in the Night number that you just saw and our evening gown competition, which you're going to see in a couple of minutes, you might get the idea that for our young ladies, the pageant is nothing but rehearsals and competition. There have also been fittings and interviews and photo sessions. Plus, as Bob is about to tell us, a lot of things that come under the heading, just plain fun. Let's look.
At Eastern Airlines, official airline for the Miss Universe pageant, some of our Latin American contestants pointed out to each other their hometowns. But there was no time for homesickness because they had a full schedule of local sightseeing. It didn't take them long to become part of an American tradition, a 4th of July parade. With Yvonne Reding, Miss Universe President George Honcher, a crowd of Miami natives and tourists, and a replica of America's favorite lady. The Riverwalk of the Hyatt Hotel, which was home for our contestants during the pageant, was the site of the makeup clinic conducted by Stan Place with the reigning Miss Universe for Maybelline, official cosmetics for the Miss Universe pageant. Miss Texas in the Miss Universe pageant? Sure! That's the name of the yacht carrying our cargo of lovely ladies in the waters off the Florida Keys. This group in their sportswear by Catalina all came to the pageant on the same airline. And on Key West, they found the very first ticket office of that airline, Pan Am. They went riding on the railroad, in this case, the famous Conch train in Key West. They shared both the experience and an ice cream cone that didn't get a chance to melt. Doesn't appear there's any need for an interpreter here. That really looks good, doesn't it? The train is going, but the shrimp boats are coming. The Keys are the source for pink shrimp, stone crabs, key lime pie, and in this case, a pretty dock crew who know how to pass along a good thing internationally. From Holland to the USA to Ireland to Guam. And what is the reward for carrying all those shrimp? Why, shrimp, of course, served with cocktail sauce and hibiscus, including one for a new friend the ladies have made, Pancho, who says thank you with a wave of his wing. The sunset provides a perfect setting for a juggler who tries very hard to avoid a hot air, but gets a warm one from his audience. And Miss Universe 1984 literally becomes a part of the city's skyline as she parasails over the water and sends a colorful message to whichever one of our contestants will eventually become her successor. As you can see, to our 79 beautiful contestants, we've added another 79 beautiful ladies. During our rehearsals, these little sisters from here in the Miami area have captured everyone's heart, and we're sure they'll do the same for you. It's time now for them to serenade our semi-finalists, and for 10 of them, it's also time to act as escorts for their big sisters in our evening gown competition. Ladies and gentlemen, the 1985 Miss Universe Evening Gown Competition. First, Miss Ireland.
Zaire. USA.
Was just beautiful, and with that warm and touching panorama of beauty and music, the third competition for our finalists has been completed. Now, in the evening gown competition, the judges gave the highest score to Miss Puerto Rico. Second place went to Miss Venezuela. And third place went to Miss Zaire. Which of our 10 semifinalists will become our 5 finalists? Well, we'll find out right after this word from Ivory Bar.
On the basis of what the judges and you have seen and heard, they have now decided who will be our 5 finalists, and I'm about to pick up their decision.
Again, let me remind you that the combined average score that each young lady got in the 3 competitions tonight will be shown only to you right there, our home audience. So let's get back to Bob. It's exciting.
Thank you, Joan. As always, the names will be called in no particular order. Here we go with the 5 finalists. Number 1, Miss Uruguay. Our second finalist is Miss Zaire. Now, Miss Spain. Only 2 more contestants who have a chance to become Miss Universe. One of them is Miss Puerto Rico. And now number 5 on the list of 5, Miss Venezuela. Now all previous scores are discarded, and from these 5 lovely young women, our judges will choose the new Miss Universe.
Our pageant
pageant contestants lived in the Hyatt Hotel and rehearsed in the convention center. Both are right here in this very building. But there was much more to see in Miami, as we're about to learn, thanks to our reigning Miss Universe, Yvonne Reading.
If your interest is old world or new world, if it centers around art, traditions, or festivals, you can count on one thing, it's happening in Miami. One of the festivals held in Miami is called Gombe, and it's a celebration for those who have come here from the Bahamas. Here's a very special band. With a very nervous guest conductor. And speaking of guest appearances, I was invited to this guy to attend the annual Shakespeare Festival of the South Florida Theater Company.
My first dream to come true was being chosen Miss Universe. The second came true when I played the part every young girl dreams of playing someday, and to say those famous lines, Romeo, Romeo, wherefore art thou, Romeo? I used to dream of saying that when I was a young girl in Sweden. Well, that's not really true. What I dreamed of in Sweden was someday saying, Romeo, Romeo, vad finns du min Romeo? See you later, Romeo.
People do not only come to Vizcaya to see Romeo and Juliet. They also come for the celebration of the Italian Renaissance. And it's really flag-waving day. These are the members of the world-famous Palio Flag Wavers of Asti, Italy, the sister city to metropolitan Dade County, Florida. From the Miami of today to the Italy of the 15th century, the flag has played an important role in festivals. Oh, thank you. While some flags are meant to be saluted, these are meant to be waved or thrown. In more ways than one, this is a banner day in Miami. You're seeing the start of the 15th annual Budweiser Unlimited Hydroplane Regatta here in Key Biscayne. These boats are about 29 feet and can cover the length of a football field in approximately 1 second. Not much good for catching fish, but just right for catching trophies. Congratulations to our winning driver, Scott Pierce.
Thank you.
From the waters of Miami's Marine Stadium, it's off to one of the city's most famous streets. This is K8 8th Street. And this is K8, the USA's largest Hispanic festival. This is not exactly Swedish meatballs. It's Cuban black beans. It's one of the many fine Latin foods, or should I say fattening foods, at this festival. You may ask how they can stay so thin. Come with me. This is the Dominican Republic Folkloric Ballet, one of the better ways to work off those calories. I got some work to do, and you are going back for some more on 1985 Miss Universe pageant.
Thank you, Yvonne. At this point, our judges have narrowed our field to 5. The previous scores are discarded, and our panel will now pick from our finalists the 4th, 3rd, 2nd, and 1st runner-up, and of course, our winner. To aid in that decision, we're about to ask each of our contestants to answer the same question. Until it is her turn to answer, each contestant will wait in our completely soundproof booth. To assist us, we'll be joined by Maritza Sayalero, Miss Universe 1979. And Kelly Hu, the reigning Miss Teen USA. And of course, our translator. Now, I am going to begin with Miss Venezuela, so would both of you and both of you step into the soundproof booth, please. Right in there. Miss Venezuela, we have an interpreter. I'll ask the question as soon as the door is closed and they cannot hear. From your friends at home and your sister contestants here at the pageant, you have an idea of what today's young women want to say to the world. What message, as Miss Universe, would you want to give on their behalf?
Por medio de las amigas que tienes en tu país y las concursantes que has conocido aquí, debes de tener un concepto de lo que las jóvenes de hoy día quieren decirle al mundo. ¿Cuál es el mensaje que tú quieres dar aquí como Miss Universo a nombre de ellas?
First of all, we have to express our love to each other. Everybody in the world needs love. I think that's very important, and we have to fight to be someone important in life, you have to have your professional life, you have to be friendly with everybody, and I think that's very important.
Thank you very much, Miss Venezuela. Miss Puerto Rico. Miss Puerto Rico, the question is, from your friends at home and your sister contestants here at the pageant, you have an idea of what today's young women want to say to the world. What message, as Miss Universe, would you want to give on their behalf?
I would like to tell everybody that they should really work hard to try to achieve anything that they want to pursue, and that always be very faithful and keep on working.
Thank you, Miss Puerto Rico. Now, Miss Zaire. Miss Zaire. The question is, from your friends at home and your sister contestants here at the pageant, you have an idea of what today's young women want to say to the world. What message, as Miss Universe, would you want to give on their behalf?
La question est la suivante. Grâce aux amis que vous avez chez vous, dans votre pays, et grâce aux amis que vous avez ici, parmi les candidates à ce titre, vous vous êtes déjà formé une idée à l'égard au sujet du message que les jeunes femmes d'aujourd'hui veulent présenter au monde. Alors, comme Miss Univers, quel message voudriez-vous transmettre en leur nom?
Je leur remercie beaucoup parce que grâce à eux, j'ai pu devenir Miss Zaire et je suis maintenant ce que je suis. Je veux qu'ils soient sérieuses et qu'ils travaillent en paix.
I would like to thank them all because it's thanks to them that I became Miss Zaire and that I am where I'm at now. I would like to tell them to carry on seriously and to face their responsibilities and to love peace.
Thank you, Miss Zaire. Miss Uruguay. Miss Uruguay. Miss Uruguay, your question is, from your friends at home and your sister contestants here at the pageant, you have an idea of what today's young women want to say to the world. What message, as Miss Universe, would you want to give on their behalf?
Por medio de las amigas que tienes en tu país y a través de las concursantes que has conocido aquí, tú debes de tener un concepto de lo que las jóvenes de hoy en día quieren transmitirle al mundo. Como Miss Universo, ¿qué mensaje quieres darle tú al mundo a nombre de ellas?
Bueno, a nombre de todos me gustaría darles un caluroso abrazo, decirles que es una experiencia maravillosa y mi amor a todos.
On behalf of everyone, I would like to tell them, give them my heartfelt thanks and to tell them that this is a marvelous opportunity and that I give my love to everyone.
Thank you, Ms. Uruguay. Ms. Spain. The question is, from your friends at home and your sister contestants here at the pageant, you have an idea of what today's young women want to say to the world. What message, as Miss Universe, would you want to give on their behalf?
Por medio de las amigas que tienes en tu país y además a través de las concursantes que has conocido aquí, tú debes de tener un concepto de lo que las jóvenes de hoy día desean comunicarle al mundo. ¿Cuál es el mensaje que tú quieres dar como Miss Universo a nombre de ellas?
Para todo el mundo, yo les mando un mensaje. Y es el siguiente, les mando un mensaje a aquellos países que más lo necesiten y por supuesto ese mensaje es de paz. Gracias.
I send a message to the whole world and that message is as follows. I send a message of peace to everybody in the world, especially those countries that need it the most.
Thank you very much, Ms. Spain. You have heard the question, you have heard the answers, and time is running out for our judges here and at home. Have you made a choice?
Miami is proud of its history, and so is the Miss Universe pageant. This is my fourth pageant, and for Bob, it's number 18. The pageant has originated live from 5 different continents, and as you can imagine, the planning is absolutely tremendous. Well, we're proud of the longest-running international pageant in network television history, and we do look forward to its future triumphs. The matter at hand is tonight's 1985 pageant. Behind me, you see some of the more than 250 press photographers who are covering this wonderful event. And ahead for them, our judges, and for you right there, some answers and a close-up look at our 5 finalists after this word from Lilt.
To further help our judges in their final evaluation, we're going to treat everyone to another close-up look at each of our finalists as they're serenaded by John Denver. It will be during this number that our judges will enter their final choices into the computer. The judges are free to vote for any one of our 5 finalists for 4th, 3rd, 2nd, or 1st runner-up, or, of course, our winner. As we all look at our ladies, we and they will be treated to a beautiful and appropriate song from our guest star, John Denver.
Like the mountains in springtime, like a walk in the rain, like a storm in the desert, like a sleepy blue ocean. You fill up my senses, come fill me. Let me give my life to you. Let me drown in your laughter. Let me die in your arms. Let me lay down beside you. Let me always be with you. Come, let me love. Come love me again. Plenas me sentidos como la noche del bosque. En el anaventes o como la inmedia. Cuando me tormento en desierto que se duele, tú llenas mis sentidos, ven a amarme otra vez. You fill up my senses like a night in a forest, like the mountains in springtime, like a walk. Like a sleepy blue ocean, yes. You fill up my senses, come fill me
again. Thank you, John Denver. Thank you so much for being with us. Now, our gratitude to all of our contestants, each and every one, and to you 5 finalists. The answers you are waiting for are in the computer, but not for much longer.
Now, our celebrity judges have just told the computer who their choices are, and while we're waiting for those results, I'm going to do a quickie Van Ark poll right here in our audience. Who do you think, my young man, is going to be our next Miss Universe?
Uruguay.
Uruguay? Oh, and you've got some other people who think so, too. How about you, sir? Who do you think is going to be the next Miss Universe?
Spain.
Spain? Oh, here for Spain, too. All right, one more time. And you, sir, who is our next Miss Universe?
Miss Puerto Rico.
Puerto Rico! All right.
from some unofficial judges, and you're going to be hearing the decision of the official ones when we come back after this word from Secret, the official antiperspirant of the 1985 Miss Universe pageant.
1 year ago on this stage, I told a young nurse from Sweden that she was the new Miss Universe. It's time now for that same lady to take her final walk and say farewell to her title. Our congratulations and our thanks for a job well done to Yvonne Reading, Miss Universe 1984.
To describe the excitement of the past year is impossible, except to say that it was a year of wonderful memories that I will keep all my life. All those memories revolve around people, strangers who made me welcome all over the world, the people at the Miss Universe who made me part of their family, and my family and friends who gave me their love and support at all times. To all of them, my deepest love and eternal gratitude. To my successor, I wish a year like mine, and to all the nations of the universe, fred och samförstånd, which is Swedish for peace and harmony. Thank you.
Thank you, Yvonne. Our final computer tabulating results, listing our four runners-up and our new Miss Universe, are now ready. They've been reviewed by representatives of the international accounting firm of Ernst & Whinney, and Mr. John LaBarca of that firm is about to hand me those results. Thank you, John. Now, before I read this, let me say that any one of our five finalists would make a splendid Miss Universe. Good luck to all of you. I shall begin with the fourth runner-up. The fourth runner-up is Miss Uruguay. Congratulations. The third runner-up is Miss Venezuela. The second runner-up is Miss Zaire. The country will be very proud. The both of you step right down here. One of you is about to become Miss Universe. The other will be the first runner-up. This is an important position because if for any reason Miss Universe cannot fulfill her obligation for the entire year, the first runner-up will become Miss Universe. Now I shall begin with the first runner-up, and then Miss Universe. The first runner-up is Miss Spain. Miss Universe is Puerto Rico. Congratulations, Miss Puerto Rico. You are Miss Universe. Congratulations. You're sad? Yes. You've won all the cash awards and the magnificent prizes totaling nearly $250,000. Now, as your predecessor, Yvonne Reading, reads the Miss Universe Creed, you walk right out and show everyone how it feels to be the new Miss Universe.
Representing the countries in the Miss Universe pageant in order to further the cause of international peace, justice, and mutual understanding, we solemnly dedicate ourselves to the highest ideals of sportsmanship, friendship, and goodwill.
This is Bob Barker with our new Miss Universe, Deborah Carthy Doo, saying good night, everyone.
A dream came true tonight for Deborah Carthy Doo from San Juan, Puerto Rico, and we're all happy to have been a part of it. For the new Miss Universe and all of us here at the Miami Convention Center, thanks for joining us. We'll see you next year, and as they say in Puerto Rico, buenas noches, good night.
Portions of this program were pre-recorded.